Our hymn of the day for this Sunday at Grace is called, O Christ Who Called the Twelve. It's number 856 in your Lutheran service book. And if we look at the bottom of our page where we get some information about the text and the tune, we can see that this is one of our newer hymns. It was not written until 1993, so this is the first hymnal that we have in which it appears. And the tune is also something that's arranged not until the early 1900s for hymn use, although it is a much older tune than that. It's a traditional English tune. And it has the name, we can see it at the bottom of the page there, Terra Beata, or another name for this tune is also Terra Patris. And that name, Terra Patris, actually comes from the text for which it was originally arranged, which is called This Is My Father's World. And we have that arrangement appearing in the green hymnal, but we don't have it in the blue hymnal, we don't have it in the red hymnal, and we don't have it in our hymnal. So we've lost that along the way. We have the same tune here, however, with this text, O Christ Who Called the Twelve. And each verse in this hymn is composed of two different things. The first half of each verse talks about something that Jesus did for or to the disciples. O Christ who called the 12, of course. O Christ who taught the 12, who led the 12, who sent the 12. And so that is the first half of each verse, is something that Jesus did. And then the second half of each is a prayer that Jesus would do these same things, calling, teaching, leading, and sending for us as well. That he would help us to do that job of being a follower of Jesus. And we know that the reality is that we do need help, because being a disciple is not easy and fun by worldly standards. Jesus warns us of that. Actually, that's what our gospel reading from Luke talks about this week. I want to read for you the second half of that, Luke chapter 9 from verses 57 to verse 6. From verse 57 to verse 62, it says, as they were going along the road, someone said to Jesus, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus said to him, foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. To another, Jesus said, follow me. But he said, Lord, let me first go and bury my Father. And Jesus said to him, leave the dead to bury their own dead. But as for you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God. And yet another said, I will follow you, Lord, but let me first say farewell to those at my home. And Jesus said to him, no one who puts his hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God. That last verse about the plow is kind of a theme verse for us this week. I think it's going to be one of the themes of the sermon. But Concordia also picks up on it, and it becomes the theme of our bulletin cover. We got a picture of a plow there and that last verse of our reading printed. It takes full strength and attention to cut through the earth with a plow. When they're driving plows in the time that Jesus is talking, they're holding the plow with one hand, and with the other they're goading the oxen. And so it takes full strength and attention to do that job, and looking back and wavering makes it impossible to do it correctly. We are called, like the disciples, to rise and follow Jesus, and to steal a phrase from Luke, from Jesus, I guess, to put our full attention on the plow. With this hymn, we pray that Christ would give us the strength and the ability to do it. To end our video today, I just want to read for you guys the first verse of our hymn. O Christ who called the 12 to rise and follow you, forsaking old familiar ways for ventures bold and new, grant us to hear your call, to risk security and bound in heart and will to you, find perfect liberty. And you will hear more about this on Sunday, I'm sure, in Pastor's sermon. But until then, study up on your hymn, and we'll see you later.